you break my bug here, huh? You break my bug!
Episode 5 of the Dirty Old Bastards WTF cast. I'm your guest host, Ryan, the Inimical, also the clan leader. Filling in for Two Still and Grampit, both who have gone MIA. Heard a couple of different stories about what happened there. I think it involves Tijuana, a donkey, and, we'll leave it at that. If they show up next week, you'll hear from them again. If not, you know what happened. Got with me today, Jake, a.k.a. DigitalHazard.
What's up?
Got, Johnny, our competitor, our training coordinator.
Hello.
You got Dabin. Who's that Dabin guy?
That's me.
Oh, yeah. He's the second in command of the BF3 side. Yeah, that's what he does.
Something.
We've got Diablo.
Yo, what up?
And we've got a new guest, a virgin podcaster with us, Jonathan Dunkz.
Hey, what's up, y'all?
Today we got a few things that we want to talk about. First, I'm going to go over some news and updates. The next couple of episodes of the podcast, we're gonna try to get in a few new segments. One called New Member of the Week, basically the best trial member that's been most active and involved, and try to get them on here, get them interviewed, and see how their experience was, and both to help other members and to improve our, recruiting methods. And the most outstanding bastard or bitch of the week, which is any member.
Me. Everybody.
Yeah, you wish. I'd like to say welcome to our newest members. We've got Revised Tactics, Jono04, and Sergeant Blue Waffle, who have been approved as full members, and a return from the afterlife here, Much 19. Don't know what happened to him for a while, but he's back now, so welcome these guys to the clan when you see him. All right, so I got a few questions, as always, for the newest guest of the podcast here, Dunkz. I've got the first question for you. What do you like and what do you dislike the most about being in Dirty Old Bastards?
What I like and dislike, first what I like is the maturity level of majority of the people in here. The gaming is fun.
You mean the majority of the people in the clan, not the majority of the people on the podcast, right? Because that maturity level is pretty low in this room.
I would say yes.
The majority of the people out that way.
Well, you obviously know the situation I had with Keiko or whatnot.
Hey, well, we handled it, didn't we?
Yeah, we certainly did. That was really my one thing that really I disliked with the clan. Another thing is these Sundays, retro gaming things. I haven't been one. I've tried to do one, and no one ever talks about them. But other than that, it's just peachy, and I love everything about it.
All right, well, so obviously, every once in a while, we have issues. We don't try to disguise it. We don't try to hide it. We just try to deal with it. And, everyone knows we take care of business. If you come to us with a problem, we take care of it. Lesson learned. We had some issues. Those issues are obviously gone now. Or at least I hope so. As far as the retro Sundays, yeah, I instituted that a while back, and it was really fun when the clan first started, but then people stopped using it. So what I think we should probably do is do something like if somebody has a game they want to play on Sunday that's a retro, go back to some older version, post it up the week before, get approval, and we'll go ahead and, give a little bit of a shout-out to it on the forums and on the front page.
Or I was saying if we do that, pick a select a few games that majority of people have and put a poll up for that week so people can vote on the ones that they have, and then if they have it and it wins that vote that week, we do play that.
Yeah, we'll get into that. We'll talk about that a little more later, but yeah, let's revisit that and actually look into doing something with that. What got you into gaming?
I played football and baseball, and when I saw college football come out and I really played it, my ideal situation was to play myself at a college since I was being recruited. Besides that, I had a friend a while back who was playing some games, and it was just fun playing with him. Super Nintendo and all that. I was always into Nintendos and things like that, but into the world of gaming. Just things like that. I just wanted to play myself and then go on the internet and seeing things like that.
So just a slow evolution of getting into it.
Yeah. You know, just that. Having a Nintendo. You know, well, actually Atari 2600. Still have it to this day. you know, so anybody...
We're really dating ourselves because several of the bastards have mentioned the Atari lately, so...
I have to mature.
Screw the Atari. It's Sega Master.
So, what about you guys? Digital, what do you like or dislike the most about being in Dirty Old Bastards?
You.
Hey, our sexy time is a private thing. Talk about something else.
No, I was saying what I disliked.
Oh, my bad.
I like the fact that, you know, except for early in the morning where, like, me and I don't remember who I was playing with last night, we couldn't find anybody online. But otherwise, besides early morning, which more y'all need to stay up all night and play with us.
Well, you know, some of us have jobs, J-O-Bs.
J-O-Bs. Okay, question. Are you European or...
Well, when I'm in the bathroom, yeah.
I never see
it
in my shoes.
I use cornflakes.
Oh, man.
But no, what I do like, though, is there is always someone on. And for those of you, in the last cast, I'm going to reiterate that for those of you that do listen to this and you complain that there's nobody online, I just got one thing to say. Open your fucking eyes. Invite people. When people invite you, invite them or join their game. I mean, you know, there's always somebody online to play, even at 4 o'clock in the morning. I'm online.
Well, what if they got punched in both eyes and their eyes are swollen and they can't open their eyes?
Well, then why the fuck are they playing anyway?
They're playing the Braille edition.
Disney Braille. But another thing that I do like about the clan is the maturity level. Of course, we all have the times where we frown and act like we're five.
Some of us more than others.
Yeah, you are fine.
Hey, I was talking about you.
Oh, yeah, I know I act like I'm five sometimes, but you know what? If I didn't be a goofball and be a dumb fuck, y'all wouldn't like me. I mean, y'all like me for me being goofy. I do like the maturity level. I do like the fact that it's dangerous. Although there are some people that I've played with that want to join that are, you know, 15, 16, 17, that are actually more mature than some of us. And, you know, and sometimes I wish we can get them in the clan just because, you know, they'd be a good addition. But I know the 18-plus rules say...
Yeah, you know, I think the same thing sometimes, but unfortunately our experience in the past has shown us that laxing that rule makes it worse, not better.
Right.
Even though there's one or two good ones, there are a few, there's many, many more of the...
Let everyone.
Yeah.
And I talked to you about that in the past, but we got that all figured out. But I do like the fact that we teamwork. I love the teamwork that has. When we start getting a full party in and we start just demolishing everybody else, I love that.
It's like in the Clan Ops the other day. We went 15 games in a row, never lost one.
I know. And I mean, sure, we may lose some or whatever, but it's one thing that I like is it's really not about winning or losing. It's about us getting our teamwork back packed down, you know?
Fuck that. All of you listening, it's not about that. It's about winning. Win, win, win. No, I'm just kidding. It's about the W.
Yeah, W. Wussy.
When it comes to kill confirm, don't rely on me. I don't have
anything. I hate kill. I hate search and destroy. For all you people that are listening, if you invite me to a party and it's search and destroy, I am no longer gonna join. Because
that brings up another thing. I want to talk about that later. Remind me, okay? About the game modes. If you're not too high to, you know, and forget.
Well, the people who don't play Search and Destroy, that means that they suck at playing this game.
But when I came back from my medical leave, I started joining games, me and Lauren and a couple other the DOB members, and that's all they would play is Search and Destroy, and I hate it. If they had, like, say, a respawn timer of even, like, 30 seconds, I would be cool with playing it, but it's the fact that YOLO, you only live once.
Try playing it when you have Sidrep Pro.
Really?
Oh my god. Yeah, everyone sounds like an elephant running everywhere. It's like you have a stand.
I don't have a headset.
Oh, well, you can turn up your TV.
that's one thing you really gotta do to
I took my headset from the computer because I have two of them. The one I'm using now has a mute button for the mic and everything.
Hey, Digital?
What's up?
Hey, we're going to have a competition for a nice headset and a nice, HD PVR pretty soon. Get in on that one.
I need to send you. I'm broke as fuck.
No, the headset one's a giveaway. The HD PVR is a buy-in.
I want to do the headset one because, I mean, what I did is I took my old headset and I plugged it into my TV because I have a mic import because it's a nice little TV. But I plugged it into that, and I love being able to hear people walking around. They do sound like elephants, but I can't have my headset on at the same time.
All right.
You mentioned about the HD PVR, because do you know that there's a lot of people that don't know what an HD PVR is? And I got so many people calling me or sending me messages on the site telling me,
What the fuck is it?
And what is an HD PVR?
An HD PVR is a STD that you get when you touch a Diablo.
When you touch Diablo. When you touch Diablo Facebook, you get it in your eyes.
Hey, I just got infected. So I just got infected.
Yeah, we'll talk more about STDs later. All right, so moving on. Johnny.
Yep.
Brian.
Yep.
Speaking of modded controllers, I did a little modding on my controller that actually seems to help. What I did is, because I have L2 and R2 for my aim and fire.
Did you throw it through the window again?
No, I didn't.
Because that's not modding.
You know what I did is I took double-sided tape to layer with it, stuck it where the button beat the controller, so that way it pushes the button down a little bit. And so I have like an eighth of a way to push down my button than everybody else has. Really quickly.
Hey, you know what, Digital? I'm gonna have to take a picture of my controller and show you these nice little $4 thumb extenders that we put on these things to do the same thing.
No, thumb extenders. I'm not talking about the joystick.
And trigger extenders too.
I know, I have the trigger extenders. But what I did is I pushed the button down a little bit, so it's just before it activates the firing and the aiming. So that way, all I have to do is a little, and it starts firing instead of pressing the button all the way down. I took away that leeway that it takes before the button to activate.
Well, I don't know about you, but I don't have a problem with getting that 1 millimeter button pressed down pretty quick. Wait, you never did say what you didn't like about DOB, besides me.
Parrots for fingers.
Don't like parrots for fingers? What? Why would you have a parrot on your hand while you're playing?
Wait, what?
I said, unless you have basic carrots, as in carrots that rabbits eat, instead of fingers.
Well, rabbits eat fair. The one.
Diablo, he doesn't understand Spanish.
What I don't like about...
Me gustaría que entendieran lo que te estoy diciendo para que ya te calles la boca, maldito desgraciado.
Shut up, Diablo.
I don't know what he said, but I'm pretty sure it wasn't nice. All right. Let's move on. Johnny.
I don't really have much that I don't like about DOB.
Oh, we don't have enough sports games.
We're an FPS clan, dumbass.
Well, kind of.
I actually do have one thing I hate. People mass inviting. We really need to crack down and stop that.
What constitutes mass inviting? Because if it's like what Aaron does when she spams me 500 invites, I agree.
Do that to annoy you.
If you that you can't join in because someone had invited you again, that's mass inviting.
Yeah, they actually screwed that up. If like say Inimical, if you invite me and then send me another invite when I'm trying to join with the first one, it'll actually kick me.
Yeah.
They screwed that up. But what I mean by mass invites, it is like say I'm in a match, I'm not gonna quit the match. When people send you mass invites and it'll actually lock up your PS3. A while ago, I'm not gonna mention the names because she knows who she is. So that narrows it down.
Hey, we have a whole 5 females now. 10 if you count half of you guys.
Right, but I had gotten massive member, and it actually froze my PS3, locked it up, and then it shut down on its own, and I had actually lost a bunch of data on my PS3.
I had that happen minus the losing the data.
But no, I lost my data, and I had a profile on Dragon Age 2 that I spent 76 hours on, and it got deleted.
Oh, you better punch somebody for that.
Nice. I'm punch your girl.
Why not?
I'll punch.
It's just a dude without a dick. It's okay.
No, I just donkey punch her in the back.
Hey, they wanted equal rights. They get equal rights, all right?
Moving on. All
right. Johnny, what do you like or dislike the most about being in DOB?
Like, probably just the organization about everything, because I was in a few clans before, and it was just, everything was just so hectic, and I just didn't really talk about it. Dislike? I don't know. I mean, when it comes up, I'll let everyone know. But I mean, it's just things here and there. I mean, yeah, it hurts me when some people keep asking the same question, when it's been answered so many times, and it just keeps getting asked. But I mean, it's nothing no one can deal with. I have no problem.
Hey, Dabin. What do you like or dislike the most about being in DOB?
I don't have enough time to be on here as much. That's about it.
Yeah, we miss you when you're not around, man.
That tells me you're not going to make enough effort to get on.
I like all the guys, man. We have a great time. It seems like whenever we group up together...
we know you like guys.
Yeah. Yeah. What about the girls in the clan? Don't leave them out either.
No, little boys.
Oh yeah, my bad. Wrong classification. Hey, just so you all know, Dabin has a red van that says "free candy" on the side in big letters.
Actually, it's camouflage, so nobody sees me coming.
Well, I hope
I'm not even gonna say nothing to that. I'm just gonna leave that one alone.
I want to know what kind of candy you really hand out.
Right.
The kind with lint stuck to it that's from 3 Halloweens ago?
Yeah, stuck belly button.
Nah, sorry, I interrupted you. Go ahead and finish. What were you saying?
Oh, or
your like?
Just about. Dislikes are just not enough time.
When you're like?
Give us a few.
Well, the likes are all great, guys. You know, we go on every time we go on, we win. Last night, two nights ago, I was on there. I got out of the close quarters because I was sick of that. It's too much like COD. So I wanted to go on Firestorm, drive a tank, start killing. I was wasting people left and right. And then all of a sudden the team started losing, people started dropping out. Next thing I know, all the DOB guys started pulling in, and we pulled a loss. It should have been a sure loss, but we won. But just every time we get together, we always win. I mean, sometimes we lose.
Not very often, yeah.
No, not very often at all. That's because we work as a team.
How do you lose?
Well, I just sit in the corner and play with myself while you guys play, but that's beside the point.
We all
do that all the time.
Wait,
Is close quarters really worth getting? Because I've been away for a while, like, I've been traveling, and I still haven't got it yet. Should I even buy the bundle that they keep sending me?
I did. I mean, it's fun. You know, there's a lot of action going on. That Gunmaster's pretty cool. You start with a little pistol and work your way up.
Wait, what are you guys talking about?
Close quarters for Battlefield.
Oh, BF3, screw that. I don't even pay attention to that shit.
You know, I'm looking forward to that new one in September. It's supposed to be all vehicles.
What did you guys think about that? Well, here, we'll get into that after. Diablo, what do you like and dislike most about being in DOB?
I don't dislike anything so far. I mean, maybe when I joined at a time of transition for a lot of things, but I mean, not really that I disliked. I mean, it was probably just I don't know, when I wasn't XO, maybe the fact that it was just taking so long to get competitive going, but now that it is, you know, I mean, and again, it was because of the transition, but other than that, I don't dislike anything. Actually, I like it a lot, and one of the biggest things that I like is that there's always somebody online to play with, and which is kind of difficult to find. Before, when I wasn't in a clan, you know, I used to get into a room with a bunch of randoms, and it was just crazy. You know, even though right now it seems like we're playing with randoms sometimes when we're playing with the entire.
Yeah.
But you know, I mean, at least there's people that you know that you can talk to and tell them, hey, dude, let's do this for the next match instead of fucking around, you know? But
yeah.
Other than that, I mean, I'm pretty cool with everything.
All right.
I'll play the fucking object. Thank fucking God.
Really? Yeah, that's.
Like, what Capricorn?
The only gripe I have is, I mean, we all play pretty well together. We play as a team. We do well. The only time I have a gripe is, you know, with my limited amount of time I get on, and I don't have a whole lot of time to get on and play. And when I do, it really irritates me when people just, like, don't play as a team. And every once in a while we get that, but, you know, if
it's seldom.
It's not that bad. Yeah, it's not that often. But
can I bring something up real quick?
Yeah, sure, what?
When we're playing, and I hope that people who listen to this actually fucking take it into action. It really pisses me off, and it pisses a lot of people off, too. When we're playing Domination, I hate when people fucking cap that third one. When we have two, the easiest way to fucking sure win it is guard those two and let them come to us and take them out.
Yeah, they
fucking cap in that third goddamn plague.
I won't major.
Right, well, that's because you're trying to get the most caps. The only...
Yeah, I'm talking normal, just Domination. People need to quit fucking being idiots and...
Pushing, you know, too far.
With that strategy, and I get people bitching, oh, I can't win a Domination. Well, what? I fucking figure why.
Yeah, because you flip the spawns. It's not about the flag. It's nothing about the flag. It's about the spawn flipping. When you flip them behind you, of course you're going to get raped.
Well, that, yeah. Then,
you know, it's about controlling the field. But yeah, but...
Near their flag.
Sounds like a training post.
Yeah, well, that's why we got the training division, you know, getting started. That's Johnny here. So if it fails, everyone blame him.
I'm going to blame Diablo.
What
the fuck? Why me?
That actually got something in my mind. The time was usually the same time, and I can never make the time frame that you have it, either to try out or competitions with that. That's like one thing I did, like, have a break with. But I just couldn't. I could never make the time because of my job or because of my travel sense. And then, or.
Well, then get with the coordinators one on one and let them know that.
Actually, you can just talk to me because I'm actually the coordinator.
Yeah, see? There you go.
For Battlefield or for...
NW3.
Yeah, for Battlefield.
Well, then you suck.
I didn't know if my war was going to be back, but I had to retire. I just got tired of little kids. It wasn't real. No more.
Well, if you want to come back to Modern Warfare and do competition, I'd be more than happy to have you.
Then I'm not coming, then. What's the point?
Well, this all leads into all this that we've been talking about. This leads into, you know, our member questions, too, by the way. The first one is, what's expected of a new member that isn't familiar with playing with us? And the first thing that we expect out of everyone, fucking communicate, man. Just talk. Let people know what's going on. Don't be dead silent. You know, if we're playing on a map, whether it's Battlefield 3 or MW3, you're out there and an enemy's flanking and kills you and you don't say nothing to the rest of the team, then, yeah, you're a douchebag.
Yeah, fucking use teamwork. I mean, come on. Seriously.
Yeah.
And also let me know that you're new, because if you're new, I actually... Because a lot of times I don't mind. I'll play with you and then I'll get to know you, but and then I'll let you know. That's the one thing, because I really don't know who is new. I try to keep up with it, but when I have, like, 800 messages that I've missed and, like, 30 just updates, it's like, I really don't catch them all. I try to read as many as I can, but I just can't.
Yeah, we all have a limited amount of patience for reading through the mass amount of messages we get. So don't expect the message system on PS3 to work. You know, use the website. That's our primary point of contact anyways.
Did everybody do the PSN update, by the way?
Yeah.
Again? There's another one?
Another one?
No. The one that was like a couple days ago.
Oh,
no.
There was?
4.21 or something.
I'll check.
I hope it did it manually.
It's not an automatic one. You actually have to go do it yourself.
Manually?
Well, and that goes into the next question. It's an MW3 specific one, but what effing roster should I be on? Well, there's two rosters. There's our normal roster and our secondary roster. Our normal roster is for all the full members. If you're a trial member, you don't get onto that full roster. You get onto the secondary roster.
Which is the trial member roster.
Also, a lot of times people say they didn't get the invite. Check Elite on your PS3, not just on the website. Sometimes they show up on one and not the other. It does some retarded stuff. It's not the admin's fault. It's none of our guys' fault. It's nothing we're doing wrong. It's that Elite was the crappiest design piece of shit that they've ever come out with. And we all got duped and paid for a useless piece of shit. Yeah, it is. I beg to differ. From the stance of all the people, all the clans trying to use it, it completely is.
Dude, I've been dealing with it lately, and... switching from the DOB recruit roster to the full member roster, and then adding people and deleting people, and it takes fucking forever.
Yeah, it is a piece of shit. Like, for looking up one individual person's stuff, it's okay, but beyond that, it is broken and pathetic. And, you know, the money we spent on it was a waste.
Yeah, that's true. If I get into my own account, and I just want to see how I'm doing, Diablo, myself on the roster and everything, no problem. But when I start trying to get into the one where we have all the members and then the invites and all that, they need to fix that shit.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, I know they were talking about a while, but...
That's only for, what, MW3 main roster?
Well, it's for any roster on MW3. This Elite's function of the rosters is shit.
But I mean, like, if you're playing from BF3 and you occasionally play, like...
If you're a BF3 player and you're playing on MW3, you automatically go on the secondary roster. You do not get a spot on the primary because we only have room for 100 members. So
that's awesome.
So we don't want to. I mean, it's only fair. We want to get the primary members in there first.
Doesn't mean you can't play.
Yeah, it doesn't mean you can't play. It just means you will have the other gold tags instead of the gold tags we have. Ooh, whoop-dee.
Is that the one with the line?
Yeah, the one with the line in front of it. Hey, look at it this way. You get one more character in your tag. Awesome. But yeah, I mean...
I got recently a guy who never plays 1-4-3. I think his name is Aitor, A-I-T-O-R, and I think he's from Spain or something like that.
Yeah.
He sent me a message and said, "Hey, Diablo, can you add me to, you know, so I can play with you?" And so, yeah, actually, they are. So, he sent me a message. I added him, and he played with us for a little while. You know what I mean?
He's our recruiting coordinator on BF3.
Yeah.
Yeah. basically, before we roll out the training, we're going to demo with Johnny a little bit and, you know, clean it up, make sure that everything works well and it goes nice and smooth. And then he's going to bring it out and, you know, train the rest of the clan. Okay. And make sure bitches don't fuck shit up.
So I'll just wait until he brings it up for the rest of the clan then.
No, you're supposed to be there now.
Yeah, you can
well,
be.
I'm tonight.
I can't be there now because I'm here.
Well, you know what I mean, tonight.
No, I don't.
Jeez.
Obviously, I'm not.
So we'll delay our sexy session. Jeez.
We already had it this morning. What, do you want another one?
You should know. We do this like 3 or 4 times every Sunday.
True.
You guys need to wrap that up.
Yes.
You know, he likes it without the lube. I'm just saying.
Yeah, first push, no lube.
Early in the morning one,
hey, Ryan.
What?
I think he's busy with something else. He's trying to take some candy right now.
Religion is...
Well, what do you think just hit your forehead? That wasn't a raindrop, buddy.
Hey, Ryan. Always remember, religion is like a penis. It's fine to have one. It's fine to be proud of it. But please, do not whip it out in public and start waving it around. And stop trying to shove it down everyone's throat.
Well, that's the part I like the most. So that ruins my day.
It does. No wonder I kept getting arrested if we're doing that.
You know, have you guys read that Most Interesting Man post? I'm gonna make that into a competition, and I'm gonna design a T-shirt based off of those sayings, and the winner is gonna get a free T-shirt of that design.
What sayings?
Are we talking about the Dos Equis guy or the Most Interesting Guy in actually DOB?
In DOB, DOB style, doing it DOB style, but the same thing. We're gonna make a video. And a T-shirt based off of it.
I didn't win that shit already.
Huh?
I haven't won that already.
Well, I don't know. We're gonna start a whole new thread on it for the competition, bastard style. It's stuff like Two Stills had, like he never has to ask for ammo. The gunner seat is always open for him. Stuff like that. But we want to get some pretty good ones in there. So you might want to not even try.
Whenever you do something in Spanish, let me know.
There you go. We'll do a Spanish edition of the T-shirt for you. But yeah, so we're going to... I just want to announce that. So we're going to have, based on that thread that I saw that was started by F-150, and F-150 for coming up, for inspiring the idea, you will get a free T-shirt if you want one. And the winner of the competition will get a free T-shirt. But the competition is the Most Interesting Man in the World, DOB style. So, gaming style. Kind of like we had in the thread.
For the design. Like, you're not actually designing it, right?
Yeah, you're just given the sayings and stuff. I'll do the designing later based off of the sayings. So, we're looking for about 5 or 6 different sayings. And the best saying will get a free T-shirt. The second best and third best sayings will also get... a discount on getting any T-shirt in the store that they want.
How much are you going to sell them for, Ryan?
I don't know. That depends on how much it's going to cost to print them. The other ones usually, I think, are somewhere around $15. Yeah, we got if you hadn't noticed, we got an apparel store that we have a bunch of gear on.
Add some shoes to it. I might customize some of my DOB shoes.
There you go.
Nike Dunks, or if you do win and you like Air Force Ones, let me know. I don't like Air Force Ones, but they are kind of easy to customize as well.
So, thank you guys for joining us on the fifth episode of the WTF cast. See us here next time. Same bat channel, same bat place. Did I say that right?
Hi, you're breaking my balls here, huh? You're breaking my balls!
If you leave that in, I'm gonna smack you.
Well, I don't think about your personality much during our sexy times.
Wussy. When we start getting a full party in and we start just,
I like all the guys.
Well, I just sit in the corner and play with myself while you guys play.
Venus Rainbow.
And then he's gonna bring it out and.
I think you guys need to wrap that up.
I'm rubbing off on you.
Right back.
I gotta go piss.
Hey guys, it's Two Steel Balls. Yeah, I had to sit this one out. Way too busy last week or so. We'll definitely be on the next podcast. This was a good one. I personally want to thank Ryan, the Inimical, and his guests for a very entertaining episode. So, at least I was fortunate enough to edit it, and I hope everybody had a good time. Thanks.